Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 15.2 Beta 4 has been out for a few days. I've been using it full time on my iPhone 13 Pro Max, and I recently switched from iOS 15.1.1 since Beta 3 was so buggy. So I wanted to share a couple small changes in this update that I didn't mention in the main video, and also talk about the YouTube community poll and the overall experience, where there's over 7,000 votes at the time of this video and over 100 comments. So we'll talk more about that in a moment. But the first thing is that brightness bug is resolved. So I've been using it a few days. The brightness issue where auto brightness wasn't working in beta 3 is working in this update. So that's nice to see. And also, of course, I have it on manual seeing that I'm outside. And also the notification summary is working properly. In my video, I said it wasn't showing up properly. It is now showing. It took a half a day or so for the notification summary to show up, and now it's showing. Also keep in mind that I'm outside, there's actually some construction going on, so if you hear some odd noises in the background, that's what's actually going on around me. Now there's a couple small feature changes that they've updated, and thanks to my friend Steve for helping me find those. If we go into the TV app, you'll see at the bottom here it says Try Apple TV Channels. The Apple TV Channels is actually slightly larger than it was before. This is an incredibly minor change, but I wanted to point it out either way. Also, if you have Beats Studio Buds, now I don't have those on me right now, but if you have Beats Studio Buds, there's some wording changes as well in this beta. So if you have them connected, let me just connect my AirPods Pro so I can show you what I mean. We'll give it just a moment. We'll go to settings, Bluetooth. If we tap on the eye and go into settings, you'll see it says left and right under noise control. And if you have Beats Studio Buds, the dialogue down here has changed. So you'll see it says press and hold the stem to cycle between the selected noise control modes. That has actually changed a little bit in Beats Studio Buds if you have those connected. Otherwise, no other huge changes. Now with iOS 15.2, many of you are already aware that this particular update includes things such as App Privacy Report, Emergency SOS, and Universal Control, hopefully on iPad, maybe new emoji, a macro toggle, and more. So it's sort of a feature-rich update, but I'm hoping for more when the final release comes out. We'll have to wait and see. We don't know, and we'll talk about when to expect that in a little bit. However, on iOS 15.1 and 15.1.1, people often tell me there's poor battery life over time, and so I'm hoping for 15.2 very soon. Now, as far as this particular beta, it is much more stable than beta 3 for me, but there's still some issues. So when I say it's much more stable, I find that it's pretty fast and smooth overall. As far as performance, we'll talk about that in just a moment, but as far as the overall use, it feels pretty normal for any iOS update. There are notification delays for some people, and one thing I noticed with notifications in particular, I went to clear some this morning, tap on the X, clear, and my entire phone respringed. That means it rebooted, it had the little wheel in the middle, and then it came back up. So that happened just a few minutes ago, and that's been a problem for me on that app, and it's acting a little odd in a few other apps. My smart lock app I talked about in the other video, I've had issues with personally. So, well, actually, if I go back, there's the smart lock app right there. The smart lock app actually just doesn't work. And that allows you to log into different Google services from time to time securely with two-factor authentication. When it goes to use Bluetooth to communicate to the device you're logging into, it just crashes. And so far, there's no update. That app hasn't been updated in 6 months. So that could be part of the problem as well. Now, as far as anything else, there's been some odd touch bugs in YouTube for me. Now, this seems to have gone away mostly on the iPhone, but on the iPad, it's still there for me. So I'll touch some things and it just won't work. I'll have to close the app. Sometimes if I touch the screen, it just doesn't work. I'll close the app, go back in, and it fixes it every time. This was an issue we had before that was fixed, and now it's back. Whether or not that's a YouTube issue or an iPhone issue is hard to say, but I think it's more of an iPhone issue since it started with beta 4 and wasn't there before. Also, that music bug is there. So maybe you're streaming, you're playing some different songs, streaming. That music bug seems to cause a problem for quite a few people, where it actually causes the CPU to use a lot of processing power and then in turn causes poor battery life. So that's something quite a few people are seeing. Of course, Apple's aware of that one and they've mentioned that specifically in their notes. Also, some other people on non-iPhone 13 Pro Max models or non-new models without the ProMotion display are seeing quite a few stutters when they're going through maybe different apps. So if you're opening up music, we'll open that here. Give it just a moment to load. We're on Wi-Fi here, but we'll give it a moment to load. And some people are seeing quite a few stutters as they're going through different apps. I'm not really seeing that, but some people are seeing quite a few. Scrolling may not be 100% smooth all the time, but in general it seems to be okay. As far as phone calls and connectivity, I've actually had no issues with this particular update. I've made a few calls, they've stayed connected, I've had no issues there, and switching between 5G, 5G UC seems to be much, much better in this update. We did get a modem update with this one, and so I think that may have fixed what was going on. I've actually had no problems with it, and it stays connected, so that's a great sign, and hopefully most of you are experiencing the same thing. The same is true with Bluetooth. It seems to be connecting just fine with AirPods and things like that, and I'm hearing that from most people as well. So most of the time I've had no issues with Bluetooth, and also Wi-Fi seems to be pretty good. I'm on Wi-Fi now. I'm actually quite a ways away from the router, and it's working. Well, I'm actually not on Wi-Fi on this device, but I am on the 11, and it is working, and for some reason it's not connected here. Let's see if we can get it to connect. Maybe we're too far out, but let's give it a second and see if we have any issues with it. My iPad and my iPhone are connected, so it should connect, and I haven't had any issues with Wi-Fi whatsoever, and it looks like I am now. So let's turn it off, turn it back on, and see if it will connect. And like I said, I've had no issues with it, and then of course during the video I'm having some issues with it. So this will be need to be reported in feedback, as there is Wi-Fi all around me and I'm not seeing any connections to anything. So that's kind of odd that I'm not seeing anything. Let me hard reboot and see if it will come back. I'm not seeing anything, so there's obviously a problem with Wi-Fi. Let's go ahead and hard reboot this. Since it's crashed on me and more, like I said, it's respring. Give it just a moment. We'll let it reboot, and we'll see what happens. Let me let it reboot, and then we'll try again. Now my phone is rebooted. You'll see it's trying to connect here. There we go. Everything's sort of coming back to life. Let's go into Wi-Fi, see what we've got here. So we could have an issue. We'll give it just a moment. There we go, now it connected. So it took a hard reboot in order to connect to my Wi-Fi network for some reason. And while I don't have 100% signal strength, since I'm outside and a ways away, it's still connected on other devices. So there's some odd Wi-Fi bug. Again, I'll have to report that one in the feedback app. And make sure you do the same as well. They'll prioritize that and try and fix things as they need to. Now, as far as performance, like I said before, it seems to be very smooth. Other than the odd issue you just saw there, it seems to be pretty smooth. Just scrolling between things, opening different applications, going into them. Of course, it's reloading. There we go. And it seems to be smooth without any heating issues. So the back of the phone has not been getting too warm. In fact, I haven't noticed it get warm at all, even using this the past couple of days. It seems to have held up well that way. The same is true on other devices also. So it seems to be doing just fine there. And also RAM management, some people have asked me to mention. You'll see it's reloading YouTube now. But one thing I noticed is that this morning I woke up, I was in YouTube on the poll last night, going over different things, reading a bunch of your comments, and when I went into it this morning, it didn't reload. RAM management has been good, other than after rebooting the phone. So going into other apps seems to be okay. If we go back to music, or go back to settings, or then go back maybe to Apple TV, because I rebooted, things will reload. But prior to that, it did not seem to be a problem. Now, as far as CarPlay is concerned, CarPlay is having some issues for some also. One user said it's dropping out or stopping. Another commenter is saying that it was fixed. So it just depends on your overall situation. But CarPlay has continued to be an issue for some. Now, in the main beta videos, I've mentioned quite a few times that benchmarks improve over a few days as background processes finish and things start to stabilize. And so I ran this benchmark last night. You'll see I scored 1,725 for single core and 4,795 for multi-core. If we compare that to before, we go back to history, you can see on December 2nd here versus December 4th, we have an increase in single core and multi-core. If we look at the previous one on November 16th, we're the same for single core, but we're better for multi-core, where we had 4,704 versus now at 4,795 for multi-core. So it definitely improved. It seems to be doing much better. And other than the issues I've mentioned, it seems to be fairly stable, but some odd bugs here and there that I do think they'll fix before it's released. Now, first, let's take a look at the battery life, and then we'll talk about when to expect iOS 15.2's next update. So battery life over the past couple of days has been pretty good, so we'll go down to battery life here. My battery health is at 100% on this phone, And if we go back over the last 10 days, yesterday I had 2 hours and 24 minutes of screen on time, 10 hours and 10 minutes of screen off time. You'll see I have a lot of background activity. I need to take care of that. But in general, it's doing okay. It's not incredible battery life, as I've used about 30% of my battery life. The day before, I had 2 hours and 32 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 12 minutes of screen off time. So it's okay. It's probably going to get me about 10 hours. However, before going to bed, having it off the charger all day, I had more than 50% battery life left. So I really don't have an issue getting through a day or even 2 days at this point. Now on iPad, I've had issues with touch in YouTube, like I mentioned, but let's take a look at the battery life. Battery has been a problem on these betas for me. And yesterday I had 52 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 37 minutes of screen off time, which doesn't make any sense at all since I don't use this with the screen off for music or anything. And I charged it, well, at 2:26 a.m. last night up to 75% and then ended up going to bed. And you'll see I only had about 52 minutes of screen on time and I'm already down to 64%. The battery life on this is getting me about 5 to 6 hours of screen on time, which just isn't very good. So hopefully it improves with the final version. When I first got this, it got 8 to 10 hours like you would expect. And I would expect this to still get 8 to 10 hours since it should, but something's going on with iPad there. Now, as far as when to expect iOS 15.2 and its final release, I would expect a release candidate. While we had a B at the end of this build number with beta 4, typically we'll have an A and then a release candidate, so it may be a little bit up in the air. However, based off of last year, I would expect a release candidate probably on the 7th or 8th of this month, maybe next week, and then a final version on Monday or Tuesday, the 13th or 14th. Typically, that's what Apple does every year, and so far, they've sort of been following that with this beta. They released beta 4 on the 2nd, where last year they released beta 3 on the 2nd, taking the same sort of break. So based off of last year, I would expect a release candidate this coming week with a final release the following week. That's what I'm expecting. They could change it up, but Apple does have a vacation period that they take off for Christmas and other holidays. So they'll take off the last couple weeks of the month and then resume in January. So that's what I would expect with this particular update. Now, before we take a look at the YouTube community poll and comments, quite a few people have asked me, should I update to this beta? And just like the beta 4 video, I would say if you're on beta 3, you definitely should update if you haven't already. However, if you're looking to improve battery life, and this goes for any beta, people ask me this about macOS as well as iPadOS. If you're looking to improve battery life, improve crashes and bugs, I would hold off. I'd wait for the final version. If you're looking to just try it out, you want to check out some of those new features, well then definitely you can try it out, but make sure you have a backup first and a computer if you want to restore back to the main version. That's how you'll have to do that if you want to restore. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the YouTube community poll and comments. Let me refresh it here. And at the time of this video, I have 10,000 votes. So when I started, I think I had 7,000. So quite a few people are commenting and posting. And you can see 16% of you are now on the beta. Last time, only 14% were on beta 3. So 16% are on beta 4. 57% are still on iOS 15.1.1, 21% are on 15.1 or older, so that means if you're on 15.1.1, you're on an iPhone 12 or 13 series device. Then 4% are on iOS 14.8.1, and 2% are still on 13.7. And I'd be curious to know why in the comments you're still on that version. Is it just that worked well for you, or you hesitated because of some other reason? I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. We'll take a look at some of the comments. There's 150. Now, I read every single one prior to this video so I could gain all of this information and share it with you. But let's sort by newest first and go through about 5 or 10 of them. Travis Myers says, I'm on iOS 15.2 beta 4 and battery life has been a lot better than beta 3. However, I haven't used the music app that often since updating in beta 3 was awful when it came to Apple Music. Overall, everything seems to be great. Now, contrary to what I said in the video, some people are having good battery life on iOS 15.1.1, where Matt Mills says, iOS 15.1.1 on 12 Pro Max, battery seems decent, no annoying bugs as of yet. Michael Taylor says, I'm on iPhone 13 running iOS 15.2 beta 4. Most things are working fine, but I'm having one major issue. Whenever I open the Notes app, I'm facing with a solid blue screen. Restarting the app and rebooting the phone seems to do nothing. The only way I can access my notes is by creating a new note using the share sheet from another app. This is extremely annoying because I have to jump through hoops to access my notes. I hope this is fixed soon. And thankfully, I haven't seen that from too many people, but that definitely seems like a frustrating bug. The frame dropping issue of iOS 15.1.1 on my iPhone 12 Pro is serious. I also have the same problem on iOS 15.2 Beta 4. I hope Apple can resolve this problem and improve the smoothness of iOS. Nick V says, just updated this morning to iOS 15.2 Beta 4 from Beta 3 on my 7 Plus and iPad Pro 10.5. So far, so good. The touch bug is gone where apps just freeze and become unresponsive and things appear smoother. Battery seems the same, fair. And I'm definitely seeing it draining faster when streaming Apple Music or Amazon Music, but the back of the phone is not getting hot like it used to. I'll give it a few days to see if any problems show up since it's only been installed less than 8 hours. Hopefully it's better than Beta 3. This was one of the worst releases I've seen in a long time. And I'd have to agree, Beta 3 was pretty poor. Diana says, battery life has been bad on my iPad 2021. Once charged to 100%, something is still running in the background overnight that brings it down to 83%. Stanley Payne says, iPhone 12 Pro Max, thankfully the car stereo connectivity has been fixed. Battery life is great. So far, no bugs that are hindering my usage on 15.2 beta. Mr. Reen says, I hope they release a very polished 15.2. The current Beta 4 doesn't feel like that, especially the music bug. Your friend in tech says, I have to say that my experience with 15 as a whole has me wondering how far Apple has fallen from their it just works experience. I don't know about y'all, but this music bug drives me absolutely crazy, and plenty of others, just far from what Apple used to be like. That's the honest truth. I'm not ditching them. I do have hope they need to polish up again. And I talked about this in a separate video where I do think they need to get things a little bit more stable and a little bit better to bring them back to where they used to be. Daniel says, on iOS 15.2 Beta 4 on iPhone 13, it's doing fine for me. D. Henriquez says, iPhone 11, 15.2 Beta 4, still experiencing issues with jittery animations when launching apps from the home screen and Siri suggestion page. Frequently occurs when bringing apps containing media elements into the foreground while several other heavy apps are loaded into memory. I've also been able to elicit this behavior on my iPhone 12 series and the non-120Hz 13. 120Hz iPhones either mask the issue or have been better optimized. Or the Pro devices also have a faster GPU, so that could be part of that as well. And so that's everything with iOS 15.2 Beta 4. Hopefully we'll see that release candidate in a week or so, and maybe we'll see some additional features as well. What would you like to see from iOS 15.2 or maybe iOS 16 in the future? I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.